Hello, anyone and everyone. I am Echo, and today we're exploring Obduction. We're back here in this cave place with tons of books and other things going on. We've got a little path over there to take, and this thing to read. So we're going to do that first before we leave. 15997 AH. Okay, the Valaine, I can't find the words. It's such a foreign life cycle, or perhaps not. They launch themselves across the expanses of space, preserved for aeons, until at last their technological arcs can hone in and carry them to a new home. They have no connection with their predecessors, but in spite of this, perhaps because of this, they have amazing recollections of their history. Their stories are epic, reaching back through the aeons. Unlike many of us who were abducted as a whole. Their scoop moved an entire facility that was about to be annihilated. I've come to believe that they, perhaps more than any of us, have a deeper understanding of whatever this strange system is that we find ourselves in. 16333 AH. I need to write this down. We buried G. Evan today. This place never really agreed with her, kept to herself mostly, depressed and downcast. Anyway, I digress. I stayed after the brief words were spoken. I was the last to leave. I wandered to the dome, as I often do, and looked out at the undulating saurian weirdness beyond the cell wall. Movement caught my eye. Now, on very rare occasions, we've seen Mofang scrambling about in the distance, but there have been fewer and fewer sightings over the years. But before me was a tall, haggard Mofang running desperately, almost directly toward me from one of the distant structures. It, I still can't tell the gender, got closer and closer. I thought it would see me and stop, or turn around, or be curious about this strange dome and our world inside it, but it continued running quickly, almost directly to my position. I was frozen in place with curiosity until my reflexes took over at the last moment, and I leapt out of the way. But rather than hit the dome and fall backward or come through into Hunrath, the dome flashed its familiar tone and the Mofang vanished. I was stunned for a bit, but I retrieved my wits and stepped into the dome myself to quickly get to the other side. After getting through, I immediately turned around and saw the Mofang outside on the other side of the dome, still running away from whatever it feared, but as if it had no sense of passing around. As surprising as the event was, it did serve to settle a few things in my mind. I always wondered how no one on Earth noticed what had replaced this chunk of Arizona we have here. 16772 AH. I got to vent. Again, there are those who argue with me. Over and over, I demonstrate that in almost every case, whatever the process was that brought us here, it occurred at a pivotal moment. They tell their stories, and they still can't admit that the abduction actually saved each of us, all of us. What is it in human nature that grasps so strongly to the past that we blame our saviors for stealing it from us? Okay, just one more vent before bed. If each of us was individually saved from something, then maybe all of us were corporately saved from something larger. Can we really be sure what's left? And this, the arrivers come from various places and times. Sarah got here almost 15 years ago from the year 2055, and Utsiel got here 2.5 years ago from 1942. What does that mean? Time here is shuffled and chaotic compared to Earth. What state is Earth in right now? When is Earth right now? 16787 AH. It's 5:13 AM, and I feel compelled to journal this craziness. After spending most of yesterday meditating with the Arai, and then most of this evening discussing the nature of these worlds with CW, I had just a sip of infamous Hunrath hooch and collapsed in my chair. Well, I just awoke from a dream. I'm not one who puts a lot of credibility in dreams, but maybe the Arai were able to move something in me to understand, or possibly, because of the intense discussion, my subconscious mind was triggered to be able to sort out some logical connections. Or maybe it was the hooch, the dream. I was tending a garden, an immense garden, and it wasn't for food or flowers. It was just about the health of the garden. I kept working and working to control it and contain it, and make it healthier. But the garden seemed to fight me at every turn, and after what seemed like days of work, I finally gave up in frustration. And as I stood there, doing nothing, the garden flourished before my eyes, growing and spreading in every direction. Because, I realized, the system that the plants were based on was not about me shaping and controlling. The natural system of plants is healthier when they are out of control, when they are free to spread and intermingle and cross-pollinate and mutate. Now, from a human point of view, that may not provide what I want. I get smaller fruit and smaller flowers and untidiness, but from the point of view of the plants, they grow stronger and much more resilient and resistant. The more they are scattered, the higher their odds of surviving. And now that I contemplate, I realize that even the individual plants thus sheathed may not appreciate the benefit of what's happening. They are torn from their origins, forced into situations that seem extreme, possibly even destroyed by these new environments. But for the seeds that survive, now that's where real growth, strength, and abundance comes from. It's so beautiful and terrifying. Beyond the beauty of it all is a system and structure that defies understanding. Okay, what if this is all a natural process? There are signs of something behind it, but well-hidden signs. So, well, if I look at all of this, the cell, the tree, the water, the seeds, the hub, the health, even the abductions, well, there seems to be a grand system, or plan. The plan doesn't take me into account. It is unemotionally intent on the health of something much bigger. That may hurt my feelings, but, well, what am I in the entire scheme of the universe? I have no idea what, if anything, might have put this process into motion, but that is irrelevant. Tomorrow I will talk with CW. He could be swayed from his battery plan. 17.145 AH. I really don't journal much. I came to write this down because I'm distraught. As I contemplate the plan that I have set in motion, I realize that I have become the destroyer of worlds. I sat down to write, to seek some cathartic tranquilization, and I realized the last thing I'd journaled was some esoterically beautiful philosophy about letting this garden grow, not so reaffirming or calming. But nevertheless, here is my reasoning, because I must write this down. Simply, it's us or them. Complexly, if this is some kind of garden, and we're the plants or seeds or whatever, well, some of us have gotten together and decided that we're the better choice to survive, if the others have unilaterally decided that we all won't survive. I am more fit, damn it. This is not me. I want to be calm and garden, or ungarden, or grow, or... What gives one species the right to destroy another species? Who gets to choose? Do I just lay down and die because the more aggressive species thinks they're better, more powerful? What brutal scale do I use to measure the good of some against the life of others? Does love ever destroy, in order to help more survive? To help love itself to survive? Does that even make sense? Can I kill because I think it will bring about more love? What if I'm not even capable of understanding the situation of hate versus love? Maybe I'm the hater. Do I generate this love delusion to help me maintain my sanity in light of the choice I've made? My god, it's too much. If these are just my walls of delusion, then I choose to live within them. I am a seed, scattered by the wind, but I will not simply be trampled. I will kick and scream and survive. May God have mercy on my soul. Okay. So, unfortunately, no indication of who wrote that journal. Obviously, probably the same person who lived here. But, yeah, they, so I guess they sort of helped start the whole war thing that was going on. Or not really start it, but, you know, something of that nature. Alright. Open that up. And, oh. What in the world? This is her house. This is, oh, crap, I can't even remember her name. The lady. What's her stupid name? Let me look at my notes. Farley, that's it, yeah. Farley, this is in Farley's house. Could I have opened this from the beginning of the game? I mean, I have to assume I could have. But that's so, oh, of course, you'd walk in through here and you don't see the tiny little crack there. And even if you did, like, even if you were walking this way and you saw that, you might just assume that it's just a section of wall that goes a little bit further back than the rest. Okay, that's kind of crazy. Huh. Alright, well. Well, now that we've got this back where it goes, I'm actually going to go back to the center of Hunrath. And might as well leave the door closed, it doesn't really matter. I'm going to go back to the center of Hunrath and use the other teleporter, because I'm certain... I could be wrong, but I'm fairly certain that at some point it's going to become important that we put the original little sphere of Kaptar back where it goes, because it has to at some point open up another, you know, area to be in. Oh wait, I don't think we can actually... Crap, that's right, there's no teleporter on this section. So we'll have to go up the tower and across the bridge to get to the other teleporter. And hopefully that one will still be here. Otherwise I'm gonna have to run around quite a lot in order to go back into Farley's house, go back into her little secret room there. Which I assume it was Farley's secret room. I don't think anybody else would have a secret room in Farley's house, and that is definitely Farley's house. That's not... It's not really up for debate. Oh, god damn it. That's still the one with, Right. We have to go through the other end of the bridge. Or walkway, or whatever. It's not really a bridge, I guess. We have to go to the other end and teleport through the shield to get to the other side where we want to go to get to the other teleporter to... To Captar. Yeah. I guess that was Farley's. Kind of weird that she... She seems to, for some reason, blame herself for starting the war just because, all the people who lived here, all the humans who lived here in Hunrath were basically, trying to protect themselves, and I guess, you know, it has not yet confirmed what alien life forms threaten them. Probably the Moray, or not the Moray, goddammit. What are they called? The freaking... Oh, no. I need to go back up. Didn't go far enough. Need to be up there. So this is going to... Just want to be further that way. Yeah. Oh, right, there's a little path down. That's where I want to go. Okay. And then right over here. Okay. So yeah, the, Oh no. The teleporter's not going to be there, is it? Because I already switched it around to get this one back in, didn't I? I think. Yeah, it... Wait, no! Oh, there it is. Okay, good. Cool. We didn't mess it up. Yeah, because this is the one that leads to the bottom of the elevator. Okay, let's go. Faster loading screen that time. I won't even have much that I have to cut out. Cool. Alright. Oh, we'll have to... Oh, jeez. Oh, frame rate, please don't do that to me. Let's call this thing all the way back. Run across. And then get going. This way. Yeah. One interesting thing that I just noted. This... bridge here that when we first arrived we had to activate it by turning on the little windmill like thing in order to, you know, get it running. That's actually I really like that they did that, because it's a extremely simple puzzle where you really only have two options. You've got one lever that moves the bridge, but that lever doesn't do anything without the windmill being turned on. And then you've got the other lever that activates the windmill. And I have to say, I really like that, because it's a very simple puzzle that is easy for anybody to figure out, but it instills a, you know, it instills a predicament, I guess is the right word. I can't exactly remember if I'm even pronouncing the word correctly. Precedent, that's it. It instills a precedent for, you know, activating machinery that gets, you know, a windmill type thing activated, and you have to activate the power first, basically, and then after the power is on, then you can do the thing that it wants doing. You know, if I'm explaining that correctly. Oh wait, no, not here. We need to go. That's right. We need to go up the other path all the way around. Oh boy. Lots of running in this game. Lots and lots of moving and doing nothing. I actually don't mind it. I just, you know, wish I was better at making that entertaining. Oh well. But anyway, yeah. No, it because it sets a precedent for, you know, getting a big windmill thing turning in order to use a machine, it sort of, I guess, would mentally prepare a player, or the player, I mean, for doing the other much, you know, not much, but slightly more complicated puzzle that that is sort of like the main thing to this area, which is getting that other much bigger windmill thing turned on in order to, you know, activate everything around. So, yeah. I don't know. I just think stuff like that is good game design, in my opinion. Because that's all I really am. I'm someone who has never made a video game in my life, never worked in QA testing or anything like that, but I've listened to lots of people who are video game critics, and I've... Oh, wait. This is an entirely new area. Wow. Oh, I just accidentally found an entirely new section that I missed before. Let's not do that, because I still want to go check out the other place. So how do we get to the other place? I think down here? Yeah, it was past... Yeah, it was down this staircase. Oh, cool. I'm glad I found that. Gives us another place to go if this doesn't turn out to be anything. No. This is the same. Except, I mean, the rocks around it are changed, but how's the teleporter here? That's weird. This shouldn't be here. I mean, it's the correct section, but there's still a teleporter. So, there's a teleporter on both sections of that? And both of the teleporters move? That's odd. I mean, I guess it makes sense. The teleporter's entire job is to switch around a perfectly spherical section of the world with another exactly same sized perfectly spherical section of another world, so it would move the other teleporter by activating either one. They would pick up that section and replace it with the other section, so the one teleporter could move the other teleporter. They can move anything, really. But it's just weird that anybody... I guess it's not weird. I guess it does make it more convenient for people to repeatedly move back and forth between those two sections, but it's weird to me because we haven't seen the game do that before at all. So far, every single time that there's been a teleporter, it's always been in only one section of the world, and so we've had to, you know, in order to go back and forth between the two worlds, we'd have to either, you know, just use the same teleporter again to go back the same way we came, or if we wanted to go through a different section, we'd have to, you know, move through the world and find a different teleporter and stuff like that. So yeah, this time I want to get a better look at the counterweight thing going across. Plus, all the mist is cool. Oh, never mind. The counterweight thing is broken off. Okay. Well, I guess we're lucky that the elevator still works without the counterweight thing on. But that does take us over here, where we should probably be able to bring this down. Yep. Alright, cool. So that opens up a shortcut for us to get back. And, oh, hey! Well, that's interesting. That is... Oh. That's the exact same... Can we even... Yeah, we can. Okay, that's really weird. Why is the computer being used as a counterweight for the stairway? Who would do that? You're gonna bang up the computer doing that. I don't know. Anyway, here's another elevator. Gotta lead down. I mean, can we even... Let me put this down again. Can we even interact with the computer? Yes, we can. Okay. And, oh, and this is actually... This is actually convenient, because I can get a better look at it this from this angle for some reason. I mean, obviously I have to, like, read everything sideways, but it doesn't really matter, because everything's written in Russian anyways, except for the numbers. I mean, maybe it's... I don't know, maybe I didn't try hard enough the last time, but, seems like I can get closer to everything and read the buttons more clearly. So that's cool. And, is that a... Is that like the... Okay, apparently the letter E is in the Russian alphabet as well, but there's also a backspace. Awesome. Oh, wait. Oh, shit. No, I don't want to do that. Shit. Now I don't know what I did. Oh, no. Uh-oh. Okay. Welp. Oops. I've screwed that up. Now I don't even remember which buttons I pressed. Why is it... Okay, so is this backspace for one, or does it delete all of them? No, that's a 9, not the... Okay, that deletes all of them. Interesting. Yep. It just... No, that's the 9. Okay, from this angle, it is a little bit finicky. Pressing the numbers, I'll have to be careful of that. And that looks like an enter key. Actually, so, okay, yeah, obviously we got the incorrect thing, so let's just leave that there, I guess. We got the, I mean, it's convenient to leave the shortcut open, and this sort of, not really, but kind of makes the, mostly, I'll say, it mostly makes the, using that machine a little bit easier. So, if we can figure out what the hell we're supposed to do with it, that will, that'll be good. That'll be good and stuff. That's a really cool... That's a really cool view of that giant windmill thing. And also, actually informative, because, previously, I... Looking at it from above, I couldn't tell that the two different blades going in the two opposite sections are actually above and below each other. They're displaced a bit. So that's cool. Alright, elevator took us down. Elevator doesn't go down anymore, I'm guessing. Nope. Okay. Oh! Another teleporter. And this one's much bigger. And will take us back to some place made of wood. Okay. Interesting. And then there's another locked door of the same kind with the same weird button-looking thing on the front. Okay. Well, we'll come back to that. I'm guessing we have to use this teleporter. And this time for sure, it actually looks like we need to put the original Kaptar section back. And I'm so happy that I'm finally actually going to, you know, that my stupid unproven theory is finally going to pay off, that we need to do that. Because otherwise we can't get up there. So let's go. And then I guess I can just go back to Farley's house and use that same teleporter to get back here. That'll actually be closest, because it'll take us back to the other place across from the tram. Oh, wait, though, there's no way to call the tram back. Ugh, never mind. Alrighty then, and we're back in Hunrath, which I kind of suspected, actually. Oh. Yo. This is where the giant sphere was. Oh, that's awesome. That's so awesome. Yeah. Yeah, this is just where that giant sphere was that, like, everybody, I think we read a note or two about that giant sphere thing, and everybody was, like, confused about what it was, or something. Maybe not. I don't actually remember that well. It, like I said, it's been a while. But how do we get back down? Where's the? There it is. There's the ramp to get down. Okay, now let's just, I guess, go back to Farley's house. That should still be the closest way. I don't think actually the other two, the other two teleporters are in Kaptar. So, since we need the giant sphere thing to be where it is now, guess we'll go back to, go back through this one. Down into her little secret room in this cave thing. And, oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. My memory is slowly coming back. I could be mistaken, but I think, actually, that we did find that little cave that led back here, but it was blocked off, because the other rocks, the rocks from Kaptar, were blocking the way, so we couldn't get in here. Maybe. I'm not sure. I think I vaguely remember seeing that. Or maybe my mind is fabricating the memory in order to make me feel better about myself and think that I didn't miss it, when not missing things is supposed to be my one and only exemplary skill at video games. So yeah, I know it's probably a waste of time, because I don't think there's a way to call the elevator back, but I could be wrong, so let me run up here real quick and take a look. A little look-see, and see if there's a lever maybe that I missed. And if there is, we can call back the elevator, and everything will be hunky-dory, nice and shiny. And no, there's not. Okay, I'm gonna run all the way back then. Great. I love the massive amount of time wasted to come and do this, just for it to turn out that I couldn't do it. Yeah, it's the best. Alright, so back downstairs, and I think if we go back this way, we should maybe... No, that definitely leads to Marais. It's got to. There's like... It doesn't look at all like a place that would be in Hunrath. It's all green and colorful. Hunrath is red and made of wood and human things. I don't know. Let's go back through the teleporter. I guess we'll have to go back this way. Oh, going the extra long way around. Excellent. Excellent. Oh god, are we not going to be able to call the other elevator back up? Because you can only call the elevators with the switches on the elevators, and the only way to get down to where we just left the big sphere is via the elevator. I don't like the sound of that. I also don't remember how to get back to where it was. Holy crap. Down here, I guess. Then, I don't know. I'll just cut this out until I find it. Okay, yeah. I luckily went the right way the first time. And luckily remembered to leave that shortcut open so we could get back here, but yeah, the elevator's down. Crap. Alright, let's go down here. Through here. Maybe there's a way to call the elevator up. With this? No, that's not... That doesn't have levers on it or anything. Shit. Okay. I'm determined to figure this out. Maybe, there's no... Yeah, there's nothing down here. That's not even related to the elevator, so that wouldn't make sense to go down there. Okay. I'm determined to figure this out. The only thing I can think of is if we... Maybe if I go all the way back to the big wooden thing and... Yeah, maybe if I go all the way back and go back to the wooden thing and, you know what, it'd be faster to go this way across the elevator instead of... or across the tram instead of running all the way around. Though we'll have to run all the way around to come back anyways. The only thing I can think of, as I'm repeatedly trying to say, is maybe if we're at the bottom and we hit the lever on the elevator, and I know the game has, like, as we can see right here while I'm on the tram, the game doesn't let me move off of it because it's moving. But maybe it makes an exception for that elevator. Maybe if we pull the switch and then try to get off the elevator, then it might let us, it might let us jump off and then use the teleporter thingy. It's the only thing I can think of. So, oh wait, we wanna... Where do we want to go? Yeah, we want to go down to the teleporter that'll lead to the secret section in Farley's house. Okay, I'm just gonna, like, cut all of this right here, and when we start back up with anything interesting, then I'll show you. Don't worry. Crap. Okay. I don't think it's gonna let us do that. And... Oh, jeez. Yeah, there's definitely no way to call the elevator up. Not that I know of. So, I think we're kinda screwed at the moment. Unless I can find something new. I don't know. I'm gonna try one more time. Send this down, and I don't even know how far away I can be standing to pull the lever. Maybe maybe if I'm super lucky, I could pull the lever while already standing outside of the elevator? I don't think so. I highly doubt I could do that. But, we'll see, I suppose. Yep, no. There's nothing... Is there anything inside here that could help? I mean, there's obviously, there's this pathway up here. But this is a dead end because it's just at another locked door. Which we need to be on the other side of, presumably, to lift a hatch or whatever right there. So that's not gonna really help. And, I mean, that actually looks just like the other side of the door. It's not the way to put it. I mean, the other side of the other door, you know? The one that we saw at the top of the steps near the machine. Or not, it wasn't at the top of steps. It was just through a cave. Through a cave near the big machine, which the big machine would be roughly right over there. And then there was a little cave to the left of it that led to another locked door that looks exactly like the one in there, which looks exactly like that, so I'm thinking that's just the other side of it, so I don't actually know what getting up there would do, except opening up another shortcut for us. So, let me try getting as close as possible. There's nothing else in here, is there? No other buttons to press to maybe send it up? Like, if there's a separate button on the outside that sends it up without... I don't know. The only other thing that I can think of, if this still doesn't work, which it's probably not going to... Yeah, this is as far away as we can be. Nope. It's definitely not letting us. Okay, the only other thing that I can think of, then, is to go back to the giant sphere in Hunrath and look at that, and maybe... I mean, obviously, when we looked at it at the beginning of the game, it didn't really give any kind of clue as to what to do, because at the beginning of the game we didn't understand all of the teleporting and whatnot, and the tram isn't back, so we can't do that. Can't go back that way over that, so we'll have to run around the long way, I guess. That's fine, I guess. But anyway, yeah, no, maybe if we look at it now, we can figure out something that'll give us a clue now that we, like, because now that we're at a later stage in the game, we understand about, like, the way all the teleporting works with the shields and the sphere machines and everything, and I don't know, I'm kind of grasping for straws, but it's an idea, so I'm gonna try and go do that, and I think I can't even remember if this section back here has the stupid teleporter with it. So I guess we'll find out, and if not, then yay, I ran all this way for nothing again, which is something of a, theme with me so far in this section of the game. Yes, the teleporter is here, thank God. Now let's go back. Take a look at that. Take a look at the thing. The sphere thing. Okay. Now, if the game will stop jittering with the frame rate, now we can run all the way back to the stupid, gigantic sphere, which has stumped me so thoroughly. And, maybe glean some kind of clue from it or something. I'm not sure. We'll figure it out, maybe. Or maybe not. Maybe this will be the point where the game finally causes me to yell in frustration and go to a walkthrough to find the answer. Oh, woe is me. Oh, Jesus. How do I even get... This would go to the other end of the... we can just walk down this way, actually. Right, there's even a little shortcut here. A shortcut which previously never really helped us. I can't remember a single moment in the previous section of the game when we were just in Honrath where that actually helped. Kind of ironic that a shortcut we opened up so early in the game is only just now, so late in the game, actually proving to be useful. Okay, so... No, this doesn't seem to help. But... No, doesn't seem to help. I mean, it confirms that if this was, like, if this was in Kaptar and we came from that direction, from where the elevator was and came up here, this would lead us up, and then this would take us to that other doorway that we couldn't get to previously, and this would take us to the doorway that we can get to with the wooden thing. The only other thing I can think of is, these weird wheels down here. I looked at them at the beginning of the game, but we didn't seem to be able to interact with them at all. But maybe, I mean, they look like they're on a track meant for turning it around. But, you know, like I said, there doesn't seem to be any way to actually interact with them. The motorcycle seems like the significant one. That seems like the one we would interact with. We can't even get on the other side of it, though. There isn't a clutch we can pull. There isn't a pedal to step on or push with our hand or whatever. Doesn't really matter. The only thing I can think of is actually the wooden platform that sort of replaces this big sphere. The wooden platform only has one stairway on it, and if we got the wooden platform here and if we turned it, we could maybe get the wooden platform pointing in the other direction, and then that would, you know, that would allow us to go up to the other doorway. But if I can't figure out how to turn it, then that doesn't help us much. Does this have power? Oh. Oh my god. Welp. Guess what I just figured out. I just followed the wire back to this button, and holy crap, I remember this now. At the beginning of the game, the very beginning of the game, I was here, and I saw this button, and I tried pressing it, and it didn't do anything because it didn't have power. And after a while, it took us a hot minute to get the power back on. By the time we did that, I completely forgot that this thing, I forgot this button existed. So when I came to look at it before, it, when I came and looked here the first time, because I forgot this button existed, I didn't even think of it. So yeah, alright. Well, then that's what we're going to do in the next episode, because I'm way over my time now, so I have to end it here, unfortunately. I kind of hate to end it when I'm, you know, when I've just, like, figured out the answer to a puzzle, clearly. I mean, that's, I think that's pretty obviously what we have to do. But yeah, so we'll have to go back to Kaptar and switch the big rock sphere thing here for the wooden platform, turn the wooden platform around so the stairs are pointing in the other direction, then we'll be good to go wherever the hell that leads us. I don't know, but that's all the time I have for now, so I'm going to end it here. Hope you all enjoyed it. I'll see y'all later. Bye-bye.